Hello, and welcome to another episode of 5 Minutes with Franza. I'm your host, Dr. Thomas Franza. In this episode, I'm going to show you how to configure your microphone. I'm just using a cheesy microphone, but if you wanted to use one, they're lying around everywhere. They're easy to get. In Windows XP, you click on Start, Control Panel, and your control panel is going to open up. If you are in a different view, this is just good old-fashioned. If you want classic view, that'll work too. But let's just stick with the way it'll probably look for you. You click on Sound, Speech, and Audio Devices, and you're going to click on Sound and Audio Devices. The secret is that in the old microphones, there's something called a boost that you usually have to set up, and if you don't, when you try to record with your microphone, you don't get anything. We click on the Voice tab. Now, there's two ways to do it. We can say Test Hardware, and we can run through that, or if you just want to take the lazy way out, you click on Volume. See, voice recording. Let's stop this. I can see it says Sound. If I had multiple devices, I'd be able to choose them, but this is a simple computer, and all I've got is a simple microphone. I click Volume. If it looks like this, right, my microphone is selected. I go to Options. I choose Advanced Controls. I click on the Advanced button, and here is the secret. If this is unchecked, my microphone is not going to have the power it needs, and it's going to sound faint at best. So you check that off. Then you would say Close. We close that, and you say OK. And that's all there is to it. And now your microphone is configured. If you wanted to test it, one of the simple ways to do it is from the Start menu. You can go to All Programs, Accessories, and in Entertainment, you have the Sound Recorder. Sound Recorder is a cute little program, and you can say Record. And when you start talking, hopefully you'll see these little lines pop up and appear. You hit Stop. Don't worry about the not enough memory. And then you hit Playback, and you'll hear your voice. Okay, if you don't hear it, then that's another possibility. No, we don't want to change that. And that's all there is to it. And now you have your microphone configured in Windows XP. If you have multiple devices, again, on that tab, you may see other choices. You may see other choices listed over here for voice recording. But that's it. And with this, you can now use it in, you can do voice over PowerPoint or anything else, Skype, what have you. But you don't need expensive, fancy hardware. Again, this sounds a little bit less exciting because I'm using a really cheap microphone and I'm not using a new computer. This is a relatively old computer. So that's it. That's all you have to it. So if you wanted to add voice to something that you're working on, adding a microphone is as easy as that. Again, just under Volume. Make sure you have Advanced Controls. Here's the secret. Your microphone boost needs to be adjusted. Once that's done, you're done. Usually don't have this problem with USB-based microphones, but if you're using older equipment like I am, this is how you do it. Well, that's it for this episode. I hope you found it useful. Once again, thank you for watching 5 Minutes with Franza. I'm your host, Dr. Thomas Franza.